violence, nastiness, threat, and pain. As they thrive in our so-called culture, we feel an ever-increasing need to protect those who can't protect themselves. The old, the stupid, and of course, the young. Pass, thank you. But violence is not an entity in its own right. And when we imagine it as a leopard or puma just escaped from a nearby zoo and seeking unsuspecting human prey, we're missing the point. Or lion. What?
Can't my ball back?
No. Because violence isn't out there. It's in here, within all of us, from the moment the cord is cut. I'm Johnny Vaughan, and this is All the Rage. No! You want to get that kid locked up, he's a maniac. Senseless violence. Phrase overused, and in fact, far more senseless than the violence it purports to describe. Violence is never senseless. I'm Johnny Vaughan. And don't get me wrong, violence can rarely be justified, but it can always be attributed to something.
And that something can happen after just 3 seconds. This is known as a flashpoint. So let's have a look at some of the flashpoints. This baseball player is about to receive one bad ball too many. Yet oddly, he doesn't go for the pitcher, but for the pitcher's teammate. Here's a classic flashpoint from a Jamaica v Mexico not so friendly match back in 97.
Oh,
that's gotta hurt. Let's take a look at that laser-guided challenge again. Cynical. Boxing press conferences can get a bit theatrical, but Riddick Bowe takes method acting a bit too far.
Oh, you can hear that! You can hear that!
Oh, you bandit! After this little smash, the first thought of the driver in the orange car is to check his fellow competitor is unharmed. Then, once he knows he is unharmed, he harms him. More baseball at a flashpoint that comes to nothing, only because the batter is so enraged, he collapses before reaching his target.
And there he is on a stretcher, livid.
This is a play we call the touchline trip. Now, this was back in the days when a potential flashpoint could be diffused with a chuckle and a sporting handshake, perhaps a pat on the back. Now, compare that with this almost identical play from a Spanish five-a-side match. Note how wily coach Fonseca is protesting his innocence before his markers even hit the deck. And look, he's still protesting his innocence. No sporting handshakes here. Those two clips clearly illustrate there are two ways you can go from a flashpoint. Just like our friend here. He clearly has two choices. He could either take a deep breath, continue with the game in a professional and sportsmanlike way, and later register an official complaint with the sport's governing body, or, on the other hand,
he could stomp some ass!
Now have a butcher's at this classic. Argentinian prop Mendez laying out Paul Ackford. What really marks this one out is that there's simply no build-up, no trouble brewing at all. Ackford has absolutely no idea what's coming. Boof, like smacking a child.
The referee was definitely right to send him off there, that no place for that on the rugby field.
Chris Everett, good to have
Here's an example of an off-the-field sporting flashpoint.
The last 5 years.
Note the way the interviewer maintains his chirpy presenter's voice throughout. There,
but somewhere along the way, Jim, you ceased being Jim and you became Chris.
Well, let me tell you a little secret. That, you know, we're sitting here right now, and if you guys want to take a station break, you can. But if you call me Chris Everett to my face one more time...
I already did it twice.
You call one more time, we better take a station break.
A clear warning.
It's a five-minute segment. Our five-segment show. We got a long way to go.
Well, we do.
We got a long way to go.
We're getting there.
Well, it's good to be here with you, though.
Well, it's good to see you, too.
Because you've been talking blindly behind my back for a long time.
But now I said it right here.
Right.
Getting worse.
I think that you probably won't say it again.
I bet I do. Okay. Chris?
Oh, they're off! Wonderful. And here's the bizarrest flashpoint you'll ever see. It's Palmeiras versus Corinthians in the Brazilian Cup final. Corinthians have equalised, and Palmeiras are spoiling for a fight. Edelson gives them the excuse they need. Yes, one man's decision to blatantly display ball skills in the middle of the park sparks the carnage. There's players, officials, hangers-on. And now look, men bound in polythene. Let's take a look at that outrageous incitement to violence one more time. By the way, Corinthians went on to lift the cup, though it took eight of them to do it. Look at the size of that trophy. Or are the Corinthians team just 18 inches high?
Oi!
Of course, how we react to provocation is a matter of degree. Half-hearted petulance is often called handbags, as in handbags at dawn, handbags at 10 paces, or the more generic, it's nothing more than a case of handbags. Barry. It's a term particularly favoured by old-school pundits, attempting to imply that any young chap who seems reluctant to engage in violence is a big gay man. It's a very nice handbag, madam, isn't it? They may be professional cyclists, but in the arena of fisticuffs, they're rank amateurs. So bad are these two at landing a punch that they have to be separated before it gets too embarrassing. Note in this replay the spectators in the background, afraid yet unable to tear themselves away from the pathetic spectacle of two men humiliating themselves into oblivion. Absolutely pathetic. Don't think all footballers are born to rage. This keeper lets himself down with a half-hearted effort, sparking a flurry of girly kicks across the park. Look at this, he's all girly shoving it, girly kicking. Oh, I think that connected. But they're all outdone by the striker, who responds to the original kick by trying to run away. Ooh, I might get hurt. The high camp continues in the bullfighting arena. Two matadors arguing over who gets the right to stab a defenseless animal. Ooh, shut that matador. She's not worth it, love. And how the crowd love it. And more handbags on the racetrack. Beware jockeys in pink silks. Get you! But you don't need a partner to practice handbags. Here's John McEnroe, king of solo hand baggery. Great attitude, and all he needs is a temper and a prop. Afterwards, Max said he never wanted to push the camera over, just up. What a pathetic excuse for handbags. Here's Mac throwing his racket as he defeats Johan Creek of South Africa. Handbags. 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 sandbags.
McEnroe's outburst came in the third set of his match against Edberg. He queried loudly and in full earshot of the many microphones around the court some of the decisions of a particular line judge. Then there was no bad language. But as he went to the back of the court after one, thinking he was out of earshot of most microphones, his outburst was picked up by ITN's.
Here's another piece of solo hand baggery. Word of warning, though, don't mention this fella's mullet haircut.
Hey, guy, nice mullet. Hey, it's a great mullet you got. Shut up.
But here's handbags at its purest, when accusations of vote rigging are made after an Aussie beautiful baby contest. Hell hath no fury, like a pushy mother scorned. Look at the fury in that woman's eyes. She's an animal.
Big women, big rage.
Now these two clearly haven't learnt the first lesson of ice fighting. It's even schoolboy stuff. If you don't brace yourself against one of the Perspex walls, you won't have the balance or leverage to land a punch. Sooner or later, you're going down. And it's that kind of low-level unpleasantness that gives birth to the three runts of the litter of violence. Milling, nudging, and jostling.
No,
give the handbag to
no,
me, madam. I saw it
mine.
First.
You didn't see
it's
it,
not
no,
your greedy
no,
pensioner. Let
no,
go.
No, no.
These, then, are the jostlers. People with no real fighting instinct who appear ungainly and awkward when they try and call on their primal voice. The man to watch here is the man who looks like a cross between Andy Warhol and Limahl. The Koreans are more advanced. They're working on the art of random reaching. Whereas the Russians like to go one-on-one. Here we see 17-stone political heavyweight Vladimir Zhirinovsky taking on Deputy Yevgenia Tishkovskaya. Fair matchup, eh? This is how the Italians do it. And more one-on-ones from Taiwan, with added lapel grabbing. But all the time, the side partings remain immaculate. Now, some of you might argue that politics is better without the rage. Have a look at this. Is this what you want? Is this really what you want? Four men sitting around a table having a dying contest? Or do you want some more of this? So how does violence snowball from one single flashpoint into a mass brawl? Now, we've seen what happens when one man snaps. But what happens when a whole group snaps? When a whole group snaps?
Roll VT.
Just roll it. Though it all starts with a clash of individuals, others inevitably get drawn into the whirlpool of a fray. Remember our so-called friendly? First, tribal instinct seems to pull in colleagues. Then, men in tracksuits. Witness the frustration of coaches who wish they were still playing and subs who think they should have been playing. Maybe they didn't start it, but they're certainly going to try and finish it.
Seguían conectando algunas patadas, entra labios, sale rebotado. El cuerpo técnico intenta poner orden. Ahí está el señor René Simoes del equipo de Jamaica técnico.
Just talk to these guys about a friendly. Here's another classic bit of snowballing violence, again at a so-called friendly. Here you can see the UN French rugby team taking on a Bosnian 15. No wonder the area is so explosive.
Thank you.
And these are the peacekeepers? Thailand versus guitar doesn't sound like a major international. But then, as Radiohead once sang, anyone can play guitar. It's another example of a friendly turned nasty, though hardly a punch is thrown. No, it's all kicking. No wonder kickboxing is this country's biggest sport. It seems to come naturally to them. Back in the political arena, what starts as a one-on-one quickly develops into a good old-fashioned parliamentary barney. Look at the fingers going in that man's eyes. Ow, my eyes! They can't leave his eyes alone. Order. Order, come on. We battered him. You've got to pity this poor cameraman. His lens simply isn't wide enough to capture the pockets of punching, jumping, stamping, maiming, goading, just breaking out all over the pitch. Watch the goalie here. Look at that, like a kangaroo on angel dust. Now we go to Israel and a National League game between Maccabi Tel Aviv and Rishon Lezion. Two men to watch here are David Benwote and Motti Daniel. A verbal argument, they're trying to calm him down, but you can see the red mist is there. They're calling timeout. That's not going to be enough. He's still angry and in he goes. Now look, they're holding him back. Look at those arms going down. Crack, crack, crack. He's getting some lively digs in there. A classic snowball. The whole team becoming involved now. There is blood above the eye, and he felt that. His mother felt that back in Tel Aviv. The man to watch here in this game between Palmeiras and Sao Paulo is the man Edmundo, who has a minder on the pitch, allowing him to pick off people at random with no risk of revenge. There's the minder there with the mullet. What is it about mullets and violence? They're going to feature quite strongly on this video. And six of you get an early shower.
Forsberg away from the play.
Here's some violence from some American ice hockey. Always a lot of mullet haircuts in the game of ice hockey. You can guarantee that under those helmets, it's short at the sides and long at the back. Oh, lovely enthusiasm. Wonderful. Two on to one. Masks off, helmets off. Let's party. Bit of gouging, grabbing the neck.
It starts with Forsberg and Igor Larionov. Forsberg with an extra hit to the head, and Igor objects.
And good fake outrage by the commentators.
And he gets the headlock, took the helmet off, and got a shot or two in. And that's when Waugh came to Lemieux's
rescue. And he did rescue him, didn't he?
He stepped in on Patrick Waugh. Brendan Shanahan.
It's cleanup time, as you can see, right by the Red Wing bench.
Trouble brewing in the South Seas as one bad tackle starts your classic rugby brawl.
Now Naitasiri breaks away. And the big action on the centre field there with Torosi and one of the Naitasiri players.
Keep your eyes on the up-for-it punters in the background, who aren't quite sure whether their assistance is needed yet. We'll see how they get on a little bit later.
There's no police control there. Mosisi Tanga trying his best. Vonulangi.
Remember our baseball flashpoint? Do you want to see how it turned out? Within minutes of this footage being shot, an entire city was involved, a revolution was started, a government was overthrown, a war commenced, and the rest is history. Kicks going in. I tell you what, if the Thai soccer team could kick a ball like they can kick their opponents, they'd be champions of the world. Refusing to calm down. Now look at this. Oh, that definitely connected. No doubt about that one. He found his back. Already a crash map on the side of the pitch. That's handy. Now, the Italians don't muck about. They've devised a sport with no rules, no referee, and no escape. A sport in which the action restarts with a punch. A sport where no one dare approach the daddy.
Mongo score!
A sport where wounds are treated with petrol. Again, you see a great mullet haircut. And yet, even in the midst of this lawlessness, real men can find love.
Everybody's called you Mookie. There's no chance you're related. As he takes one in the back, and yeah, now he's not going to like
it. And he rejects him now. Yates and Wilson are into it.
Everybody's on.
Oh, amazing scenes.
Here's another piece of snowballing violence, this time from Aussie baseball. Note that while in Britain, fights, like streakers, are denied coverage, in Australia, they're seen as a bonus and get commentary, analysis, and action replays.
Well, there must have been something going on before. Yates still wants a piece of Wilson or anyone else he can get his hands on.
Well, Wilson is hit here in the back. He's not hit intentionally. The ball just gets away, but he doesn't like it. He takes a few steps toward the mound. Now, when he does that, the catcher is just going to step in there and try to stop things immediately. Now, when Yates brushes up against Wilson, Wilson didn't like that, and then Yates and Wilson went after it. Now, it looks like there's a skirmish starting again.
They just want to leave it alone, these players.
You see, he's giving it sensible sporting analysis.
And it's the guys from the bench that are causing more of the problems.
And finally, check out this Arab football clip, which brings new meaning to the phrase, tackle from behind. This clearly shows the lag between the moment of actually being kicked in the nuts and the moment of actually realizing you've been kicked in the nuts. Great footage. Of course, you can't tar everyone with the same brush. Some people are perfectly happy going about their everyday business right in the epicenter of the maelstrom.
Yeah, I must have weakened them. City trying to undermine me.
Two things to note here. Earth's largest picture frame in the background, easily. And also the chap in the middle, who carries on reading, oblivious to the projectiles whizzing past his head. I wouldn't mind betting there was a jazz mag in there. Here, a lensman with a keen eye for an action shot foolishly keeps his camera trained on the pitch. Just like this ineffective ref here. Look at him, he's just staring away. He doesn't want to know. And here's the aftermath of that touchline trip. How do you practice keeping up with all this going on? Ask that coward.
Hello there, I'm Johnny Vaughan, and the one place where you or I feel safe from hostility is in a crowd. It's strange, you can be close enough to a ruck to hear the sickening thwack as knuckle meets cheekbone, close enough to smell the fury And yet, you yourself don't feel threatened. It's as if the anonymity of the masses gives you a degree of bottle you'd never dream of exhibiting on your Todd. But how safe are you?
Fuck with me.
Not very safe at all, as this pushy journalist finds out.
I'm wrong, but I ain't gonna talk to you. Fuck with me. LT. Man, this is unnecessary, Betty. Don't tell me fuck me, fuck you. Dilly silly bitch.
Diddly siddly bitch indeed.
In basketball, the crowd are virtually on the court. How safe would you feel with all this kicking off inches away? You wish you'd taken those tickets in row V and stuck the mother-in-law and the wife in row A.
Lesson: if you're gonna have a pop from the stands, make sure there's at least one tier separating you from the big players. Oi, Ronaldo, give it up, you're rubbish! You see? One tier of safety.
Chivas made on Esposito.
You always get some reckless O's insisting on testing the maxim, safety in numbers. Well, when this chancer steals O'Reilly's hockey stick, he steps over the invisible line.
Oh, this could be bad. Oh, there go the Bruins.
No longer are these two ice hockey player and man in crowd. No. Now they are furious, adrenaline-charged maniac and man who has stolen furious, adrenaline-charged maniac's property.
He's not swinging. To McNabb's credit.
And it's left to Blakey out of on the buses to pick up the pieces.
The whole Boston team is up in the stands. The Rangers have stayed on the ice.
The fan grabbed Riley's stick. Riley went after the fan and the stick.
That's not ice hockey. That's a riot.
Pretty soon, there's going to be too many fans up there around them. I hope they can back down on the ice.
Esposito had been back in the dressing room. He came back out.
This is why they have fencing at football grounds. The chap in the number 5 shirt is trying to kick someone in the head through metal. Good grip on the fence, poor grip on the laws of physics. And now his mate from Hanson wants a go. It's not as if there's not enough people fighting already without dragging Hanson in. Seconds out, chairs in. Here, you'd think there's no chance of crowd involvement. Look at the height of that fence. But then look at the width of the fence. And therein lies their error. The fence simply isn't wide enough to keep back the fans. Someone here obviously watches a bit of Monty Python. Look at the way this foot comes down out of nowhere from the top of your screens. Here's some more crowd trouble. And here's some more chairs for you. More basketball, and while the blue number 6 sensibly runs away from danger, the fat bloke in the crowd has lost all sense of reason. As the red mist descends, he viciously pats a man on the head. Crowd hand baggery at its very best. Blatant.
Now, our friend from Hanson never made it to the pitch, but in this rare clip, his pop buddy, JK, from Jamiroquai, he's having a field day. Now, see the guy there in the white shirt and tracksuit bottoms trying to calm things down? The crowd absolutely hate that, and they chase him. All this oaf wants to do is lamp the ref and Scarpa. The linesman, though, has other ideas. But the prospect of going 1v2000 ultimately cools his rage. In the footage we've seen so far, law and its sometime bedfellow, order, are conspicuous by their absence. Where are the authorities when good folk turn to bad? OK, here's an example of effective means of control. Look, the players are actually telling the ref to calm down.
O juiz falhou ao ordenar o reinício do jogo com Edilson em campo. Mas a partir do momento em que a bola rola, o pênalti deve ser marcado.
This is the kind of control we like to see. A ref relishing, red-carding, not one, but six players at a stroke. He's also easily the most aggressive person on the pitch. That's how it should be. But this kind of mastery is all too rare, as this piece of film shows. Conflict in the public arena should be nipped in the bud. Sometimes, though, ineffective means of control allows the violence to spread unchecked. And what passes for security in the Japanese parliament? A man with a whistle. Useless.
Now, this is a sad day for Fiji rugby.
Now, you remember that Fiji rugby brawl? Only some time after the crowd spill on do the police get involved. And yet, strangely, they seem to have little authority.
I second and tell them they've been stamped on. No police control at all in this match.
Is it because they lack training in riot control? Is it because they're poorly equipped? No, it's because they're wearing dresses.
And you cannot control a riot if you're dressed for panto.
Even the referee has been chased. Watch all that.
Coy never saw that coming. Ooh, we'll remember that on his birthday. This time, there's no problem with the uniform. He's got that right. It's just that the man wearing it seems to be a traffic cop. Look at the way he tries to direct people. It's useless.
And when things finally get out of control, what does he do? He pulls out a long dildo.
And what about that fight in the Russian parliament? Notice the only ones restraining Zhirinovsky are his colleagues. The military man, he just looks stoned. I'll just go and restrain some dude who, like isn't fighting, man. And I'd love to know what this Brazilian ref, getting kicked in by a team of Brazilian lady footballers, told his mates in the pub.
I fell over on the ground. This guy come up to me, started hitting really hard. I put up a biggest struggle.
Now here's a classic. The Spanish ref who sent off four players and then legged it. Such ineffective control, he's literally running for his life.
And you get the feeling here that actually they're saying, no, come back, it's actually all right. And please, please come back, it's all right. Forget it, mate. He's like, no, sod that, I'm off. And off he goes. Come back. And that guy wasn't trying to pull him back, he's trying to reassure him, look. But no, fear has taken hold.
But even if you stand your ground, it doesn't mean the violence will stop.
Looks under control, doesn't it? All looks under control. Bang, bang. Now the referee wants to know. He's like, come on then, come on then. Come on, I'll take you all.
Oh, sweet little jab.
Here they go.
Great use of little chat. Have a look at this. Masks are off. You know that means trouble. Remember, just a little chat.
He wants to go with Small. Now the goalies square off, and they're into it. And they're big
Even the commentator's getting distracted with the whole mask issue. But loving every second of this on-the-wall action. Look at the encouragement from teammates. Go on, you can do him! You can do him, dude! Take him out, dude! Come on, man! You're the man!
Brad Lazarowicz, Wayne Bonney have their hands full.
So many police, so little authority.
Sounds like a little torture circle there.
Right, remember the fence kicker? Here's that clip again. This time, keep your eyes on Fat Cop, the uber dork of ineffective policing. He wants to give a semblance of involvement. He grabs a player, and then he just hugs him. Now look at him here. He can't even bear to watch the fighting, let alone try and stop it.
Still pathetically restraining the player. The player just goes back in the action.
No, honest, I've calmed down. You can let me go. You promise no fighting? Yeah, whatever. No, I mean it. Yeah, just let me go, Fat Cop. All right, then. You fibbed. Look, you're hitting someone.
Oh, hello there. I'm Johnny Vaughan. So, we've established that we all have a breaking point. In fact, all that separates us is the degree of provocation needed to bring down that red mist. Butcher, priest, prostitute, or gas fitter. We can all snap. But why? Why has evolution given wild animals the ability to digest raw meat, but given men and apes the fist? Whew. Can violent behaviour be learnt? Dr. Gavin McNamara of Brunel University has just concluded a 5-year study into fury in all its forms. I'm going to have a talk to him right now. He's on the line. Dr. McNamara, do you think immersing a subject in graphically violent material over a lengthy period of time could lead to that subject becoming increasingly combative and violent themselves?
Do you want some? Hey? I said, do you bastard want some? Come on then, let's finish it outside, you totter!
Perhaps these clips will be a little bit more instructive. Yes, well, I can see your point of view.
Now, this is a sad day for Fiji rugby.
The Science of Violence, Module 1, commentaries. Watch the Fiji brawl again, but this time, see how the commentator's negative tone spoils the spectacle.
The super players are simply chased off the field. A black day for Fiji rugby. Well, the bad boys of rugby are in action again.
This is not rugby, and this is just pathetic.
Now compare and contrast their downer with the positivity of these Aussie commentators.
Yet, Sedaris has thrown the first one, and we'll have plenty involved in just a moment.
Brawls have broken out. Hopalati. He might be in his first Origin match, but Barnhill's involved. Well, we've seen plenty of this in Origin. This is one of the best.
Hear that? This is one of the best. The commentator giving out like a stamp of quality.
Allen and Harrigan, the two heavyweights.
Module 2, interspecies parallels. We all know how the lion divides to conquer, separating the weak prey from the herd. Just as here, with their teammates disappearing down the tunnel, a sense of impending doom descends on the three stragglers cut off from the herd. It's worth seeing this one again, actually. This time, watch the blue team's goalie and one of his teammates. They both chase the stripy team down the tunnel in the mistaken belief that the rest of their own team are right behind them. They were never seen again.
It's
It's 1:30 in the a.m. and I've just been woken up by a disturbance in the rear of my premises. Now, just in case I've got to go mano a mano with an intruder, I've instinctively grabbed the first object that came to hand. You see, ever since caveman first wielded club, the instinct to get tooled up has never deserted the fighter.
Our friend Vladimir's weapon of choice is surprisingly mild. It's water. Water, an effective close-range low-grade tool. So what's behind Zhirinovsky's ploy of filling the glass? A decoy, making his opponents think he's thirsty. Good manners. Or plain old physics, a wider surface area allowing for greater coverage. And who's the object of Zhirinovsky's hate? Why, it's the hairy cornflake himself, former Radio 1 DJ DLT. He seems keen to try a range of projection options. Meanwhile in India, high noon. It all starts innocently enough with cordial paper waving. It's angry, but it's not violent yet. There's a chair. That's a suggestion it's about to go off. Chairs are up. Authorities moving in. It's off now. You can see it spilling over in the foreground. Now, that's spilt over now. That is now a violent conflict. Now it's off. Noteworthy about this is how sort of juvenile it is. They're all ducking behind and throwing things. Luckily, he's protected by a file and a cushion. Now look at this guy. And then he ducks down behind. Hide. How can they keep missing with weapons this big? Must be deliberate. The South American Super Cup. Vasco da Gama versus River Plate. So far, two sendings off and a goal, and the crowd go wild. They start by throwing shoes, then they escalate through firecrackers, and then they go to chunks of concrete.
And then somebody throws on a wheelbarrow. And that is not cool. Now watch this late punch. Here it comes, bang. He goes down, and out come the chairs. But instead of throwing those chairs in like a boxing crowd should do, they throw spaghetti. It's laughable.
Rajiv again.
Here's a Punjab police hockey team taking on Indian Airlines.
No, I didn't hit him. He fell down the stairs.
Now, I don't know what it is about mullets and hockey sticks. The two seem to just encourage violence together. Look at the big number three. He just loves violence. And he's got a mullet. And there's mullet man now. He's onto the goalkeeper. Look. Bang. But he won't hit a fellow officer.
Even Harinder has been injured, he's lying there near the goalpost.
Meanwhile, back at that friendly between Jamaica and Mexico, the Jamaicans have been away foraging for sticks and stones.
las armas blancas, los jugadores del equipo de Jamaica. Regresaba el orden, parecía que en ese momento...
There's a lovely sense of simmering violence here. People just waiting for that flashpoint that means they can all get involved. There's the tree line there, some people just returning from the shrubs, tooled up, waiting for their moment. It's been ugly, and it's been by no means a friendly game.
No, don't worry, that's just the design of the shirt.
Perdió el conocimiento, tuvo que ser llevado a una ambulancia. Vean a Murillo descalabrado, jugador de Toros Neza.
As you watch this, remember the word friendly.
Afortunadamente no hay más lesionados en lo que era un partido.
Lacrosse. They're la furious. This Barney in Taiwan starts off as a game of capture the flag. Eventually, Deputy Lee Cheng Long says, enough is enough. Off comes the jacket, and off comes the shoe of justice. Boof! Boof! We leathered him! Bring forth the shoe of justice! The flags are replaced, but the shoe was never found.
Okay, there is definitely an intruder in there, yeah? And yes, I'm scared. I'm going to summon the rage to cloud the fear. Yes! 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 Let's do it! It's you! Right, you want that handbag, you try take it from me, old woman. Let's wrestle.
Look, this dog is useless. It's swing ball, isn't he? He's a Jesus, for fuck's sake. Violence, nastiness, threat, and pain. As they thrive in our so-called culture, we feel an ever... Violence, nastiness, threat, and pain. As they thrive in our so-called culture, we feel an... Violence, nastiness. Oh, this dog is shit!
Don't worry, just keep playing it, just keep playing it.
Just fuck off, don't hit it, dog man. I'll do it, just flounder. The old, the stupid, and of course, our old friends, the young. Pass, just do it again, bit quick. You passed it before I said pass, okay. The young. Okay, let's do it again. I have to say pass. If you wait for pass. The young. Pass! The young. Okay, do it again. You wait for me to say pass. Leave. Leave, dog! Oh, shit. Yeah, all right, mate. I'm concentrating on the dog and the swim ball. Why is every shot made so complicated? Because violence isn't out there. Oh, you see, you moved to the mark, so it's just about there then, yeah? Because violence isn't out there. Near. Because violence isn't out there. Oh, sorry. Sorry. There you go. Yeah, that's it.
All right.
That's perfect. That's brilliant. It's perfect. In the footage we've seen so far, Law and its sometime bedfellow, Order, are conspicuous by their absence. So where are the authorities when good folk turn to bad?
One more. If you can't...
This is just shit. Sean, it was briefly amusing when Harvey was here. Did the first take not work?
It was good, yeah. It was good. Do you want to just leave it at that?
I think just leave it at that then.
Okay, it was a good one.
Perfect.